So you believe in Jesus God?
Yeah.
Okay. As a Muslim, we believe in God as well. But we don't believe Jesus to be God. The reason being, we can analyze and tell me what you think.
Yeah.
Like all of us here, we believe God is perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Correct?
Yeah.
And we know that God has more knowledge than anyone else.
Mm-hmm.
There is no one has more knowledge than God. Do you agree?
Yeah.
So if Jesus is God, by default, no one should have more knowledge than him.
Mm-hmm.
But according to the Bible, Jesus, he didn't know the hour.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't know the hour.
Yeah, yeah. Mark 13:32.
But wasn't he truly human?
In Mark 13:32, Jesus said, no one knows the day and the hour. Not even the angels in the heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. The Christians didn't say Trinity. They say the Father.
Sure, I'll get.
There is the Father.
Because Jesus himself answers this question. Hey.
There's the Father.
No,
there is the Son and the Holy Spirit. So there's the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Are you bringing Jesus up? Is not the Father, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Jesus is not the Father.
He said, "Don't." When you break it down like that, that's when the whole fundamental, the whole thing, the foundation
according
of it,
to Jesus,
you're trying to rip
Jesus.
It apart. You don't understand. The Trinity is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit
so
in one. That's it. You can't peel it apart.
Okay, so let me understand. So when Jesus getting slapped in his face, is that the Father getting slapped?
Jesus and the Father are one.
So my question to you, if imagine me and the brother here, we are one. In what way one? Essence?
It's
what is purpose?
Listen, Shamsi, if you
ask
don't understand...
Ask me too many times, I want to speak to you.
No, it's my big brother.
I want to speak to
you.
Many
times.
Ask me too many times.
Shamsi.
Does it feel like we're in the house? Does it feel like we're in the house?
Obviously got that reference.
I've
got the reference.
Nothing. Okay, go.
All right, Shamsi, you need to understand the concept of the Trinity first. Before you even...
I don't understand it very well.
Before you delve into this sort of thing you've conjured up, you need to understand the Trinity very well from the Old Testament, right? So if I ask you a question, how did Moses speak to God? Or what did God say to Moses? How did God communicate to Moses?
God spoke to Moses directly.
How?
How does it say? Through the bush?
From the text.
From the text, the Old Testament, for the fire bush.
No. See, now you're beginning to understand that he doesn't really know the Bible.
No.
Break it down and I'll show you.
No. God spoke to Moses, according to the Bible, from the fire bush. Yes, or no, did you?
No, let's listen.
I'm asking you.
I made a claim, so let me back up the claim so that...
Okay.
So this is Numbers 12:8,
yeah?
With him I speak, addressing Moses, with him I speak face to face, clearly and not in riddles. He sees the form of the Lord, right? Why then were you not afraid to speak against my servant Moses? Right? So God speaks to Moses how? Face to face.
That's contradiction, though.
That's what I said. You don't really understand.
No, wait.
Let me just make my foundation.
That's what I'm saying to you two, because you brother never let me speak.
No, you can speak.
That's. We could do it the easiest way, yeah? Let me arbitrate. Let me just mediate, yeah? One makes their claim, you guys come with a
counterclaim.
My claim that Jesus cannot be God.
Sir, let me get here.
My claim Jesus cannot be God. Naturally, Jesus cannot be God. That's my claim. My claim is
that Jesus cannot be God.
Naturally,
intellectually,
and also textually.
So what is the counterclaim?
Physically. Okay, fine. My premise was that the Old Testament. You can see. My premise is that from the Old Testament, which you claim to understand, and you go on like you know, like the whole Bible. I asked you a simple question: how did God communicate to Moses? And you said through the bush. But
did he or not?
Yeah, of course he did. But
so no.
Which is really fair.
Come on, bro.
He's not speaking. It's because he's cutting him off now. You get me?
Let me continue. Shanti, calm down.
No, because he's like, I don't know the Bible.
No,
you don't know the Bible.
You haven't delved into the Bible. You can come here. You haven't delved into the Bible deeply to understand. The Trinity, the foundation.
Go on.
So, I've told you.
There
you go. This verse here. Exodus 33:11, right? The Lord will speak to Moses. What does it say there?
Say face to face.
Oh, wow. You just became a Christian. Why do it now? Let's continue.
This is like Jesus.
Let's continue. As one speaks to you.
Just friend.
As one speaks to a friend. Ain't that amazing?
You speak, then I speak.
Ain't that amazing?
How is your speech going?
No, I'm just giving you a premise so that you can work off. Do you understand? So
that's my premise.
There's certain things you don't understand about God's nature, right? And when Moses asked to see the glory of God, or see, yeah, to see God's glory, right? We need to delve into the text to understand how God communicates to a man, right? Before you start saying, oh, he's not a man, he can't become a man.
So better, yeah, my brother, yeah. What about the essence of being an actual God? What is the essence of a God?
Essence of being a God.
Essence of being God.
Good question.
No, I haven't actually my point. I haven't done my point.
With your question, what question? How can Jesus be God?
No, it's
what was your
question? Watch this.
Question was Jesus couldn't be God.
Why Jesus cannot be God? He mentioned
why he cannot be God.
Why can't why Jesus can't be God? The question Baba asked, this guy here,
I spoke to many times. So I thought, you, because you're new guys, I can speak to you. But because you choose to let him speak.
No, I can speak by myself.
So let us speak.
What's your question?
No, okay, let me speak, let me speak to you because I spoke to many times. Now, you,
no problem.
You have a brain, correct?
Yes, I have a brain.
Okay.
Yeah. We all knew between the
okay. If I say no one is greater than God, what does it mean?
No one is greater than God.
Yeah, what does it mean?
Exactly what you said.
God is the greatest.
It means, yeah, God is the greatest.
So
yeah,
if someone or something claims to be God, but something or someone greater than it or than him, can the same person who claims to be God, can be God?
Let me say this. You see the God that I serve, yeah? He cannot be limited. The God that I serve, he cannot be limited. I cannot tell him he can or cannot be this. In my sense, my God is omnipotent, omnipresent. He can be anywhere and he can do all things. He created this whole world. Do you understand? I have never limited my God to anything. If my God is giving me the word and he says that the word, he is the Holy Spirit, the word, Jesus and the Father, I will believe that because he can do all things. I've never limited my God to say there's only one God. You can only be one God. That's what you say. There can only be one God. Like you are telling him that you can only be one. I'm telling you that my God has told me that he is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I have to believe that because he has created me as well as all things. So straight away from that, that's my father. I believe
okay.
my father.
No problem. So
that's it. So you cannot rip it apart.
No.
So this, listen to this. Your understanding,
let me speak now.
Your understanding is different from God's understanding.
No, when you just speak, you become a Sikh and a Hindu.
Huh?
You argument same as a Sikh and a Hindu.
You see, no.
Why I'm saying that, basically, I'm a Muslim. Why? Because Allah said Islam is the truth, therefore you cannot question me. That called circular reasoning, which is what? It's illogical arguments. I'm saying God gave us a brain to utilize. No, hear me out.
Let me finish my bow.
My question is clear to you. Is there anyone greater than God? You said yes. If this is the case...
I didn't say yes.
He said no. So therefore, God is the greatest, correct? If God is the greatest, you're already negating something that undoes it, which is what? To be ruler. Without any doubt. To tell me God is the greatest and is low at the same time, that's called law of contradiction, which doesn't exist in the real life. Jesus clearly said, the Father is greater than I. If Jesus and the Father are one, therefore no one should be greater than the other one. The fact that Jesus said the Father is greater than I, that's a clear cut. Jesus is not God. Also, Jesus said, I'm going to my God. Does God have a God? My question, does God have a God? Does God have a God?
No.
Of course not. Does God have a God?
No.
No. So Jesus the Bible said, I'm going to my God. So you just refuse your own Bible.
How
about
yourself
now?
How did Jesus address him?
I'm 23.
So you can speak.
Yeah, but he brought me here today because I've never been here before.
Yeah.
So I'm coming here to sharpen myself as well as to understand.
Are we taking you somewhere else? We're talking.
Yeah, we're talking, but the questions you're asking me, you're asking it in a way where you're directing the answer you want.
No,
me.
That's your answer.
Jesus God, yes or no? That's the answer that you've kind of, you already know the problem.
No.
So I'm saying that.
That's the reason. So I'm asking you. I'm asking you.
Cheers, bro. Cheers, cheers.
David, I'm on a chassis. David, we're asking you to reason with me.
Yeah?
Go on.
I can reason with you, but what I'm saying is that the way you've come, you've formed these questions and you're asking me, it's just straight away defuse whatever I'm going to say. That's what I'm saying.
No, it's simple. It's simple. It's simple.
You said that Jesus said, no, no, to my God and your God.
Yes.
Right? Have you read the verse?
Yeah, I read it.
All right. So now this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent, yeah? I have brought you glory on earth by finishing the work you gave me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in the presence with the glory I had with you before the world began. So how did Jesus share glory with the Father before the world
began? That's a good point. You see what I did? He read it without understanding.
Yeah. How can I read it and not understand
it? I'll tell you how. I'll tell you how.
But then again,
no, I'll tell you how.
You quoted the verse, but
you didn't. I'll tell you how. I'll tell you how.
Tell me how God, how Jesus shared glory with the Father before the world began.
Me,
and only Jesus.
No, I'll tell you how. First of all, Jesus called someone true God. Who is the true God here?
Obviously the Father.
The Father.
He's addressing the Holy Spirit because of
wait. What you see what I did? He used something for me in my favor. Jesus called the Father the only who?
True God.
Who's the only true God according to Jesus?
The Father.
So therefore, anyone other than the Father, what is he?
The false God.
According to Jesus?
Is Jesus, did Jesus say,
Jesus.
Take what Jesus said.
Jesus.
Let me finish.
Go ahead.
So, including Jesus, so Jesus is saying the Father is the only true God, right?
Jesus said that. Jesus said that.
And Jesus said also, I and the Father are one.
Which contradiction?
Contradiction.
I'll tell you how.
I'll tell you how. But before, I want to ask you.
What do you mean before?
Is Jesus according to the...
No, before you tell me, I'll tell you how. No. I'll tell you how.
If you don't know who Jesus is. If you don't know who Jesus is.
Let me speak now. You ask me how.
No, before you bombard, let me lay down the
question. Ask me a question, let me understand
the least. Because you're coming from an area, you're not understanding the Bible, you don't understand the Torah.
You read the Bible, God, I'm guessing.
Let me finish, man. Let me finish. So, you're saying that, and this is the point I'm making.
No, I'm making a point, this is contradiction.
I know your point, you said it's contradiction.
But why?
But Jesus is the word of God, right? You agree?
No, I don't agree.
You don't agree that Jesus is the word of God?
No, I don't agree.
So see, you're coming from a premise where you already deny the word. So how can you understand it from the Bible?
When
the Bible
says,
the
premise of this conversation.
He's clear about the word of God, that's why I believe as a Muslim.
The premise of the conversation is that Shamsi made the claim that Jesus isn't God through
rationality and
testimony.
So now wait,
you're saying Jesus, or you just that claim he made,
it's a different subject.
You don't understand who Jesus is. You don't understand the person he is in the Trinity.
You said why that's contradiction. My brothers, everyone here speaks English. Correct.
He's not the father.
You said this contradiction.
The Quran, it says Allah is a father to no one. So if Allah is not the father, he already falls out.
My point here. Jesus said the only true God is the Father. That necessitates anyone other than the Father is a false God. Do you agree?
Of course, yes.
Is Jesus the Father or other than the
Jesus
Father?
Said I and the Father are one. So he doesn't fall out of that.
Okay.
If Jesus is making a direct quote saying I and the Father are one,
you don't know where you see the Father.
Can you say that?
Okay, I can't say that. That's not true. Is the Father Palestinian Jew?
Can you say that?
Is the Father Palestinian Jew?
His image was Jesus Christ.
So
when Jesus said,
you
see the image of God.
So God looks like Jesus, he has a penis and he has a chest.
Did Allah create you in his own image? Did Allah create you in his own image? Thank you. Allah didn't create you in his own image. What God are you worshipping?
I worship the God of Abraham.
That God doesn't exist.
It exists.
Your Allah doesn't exist.
Your God is
because your Allah didn't create human beings in his own image, like the Bible says, and to
human beings.
Jews even
so
agree.
So okay, so hold on. Wait. You are going off topic. Stick to the main point. My problem.
Simple. So what's your problem?
My problem here is that your Bible seems contradictions.
And the proof of the Quran.
The proof of
the Quran is a joke.
And I'm going to okay.
Do you know
it's a joke?
Do you know it's a joke? What do you mean by altar? What do you mean altar?
Do you know what is a joke? Do you know what is a joke?
That's a big claim.
Brothers.
It's a big claim to make. God,
do you know what is a full joke? God got beaten by a group of people. That's a big joke.
What
you God, listen. You God is weak in America.
Listen, Muhammad is a Christian. No. Muhammad didn't even say Muhammad. Never say Muhammad.
Do you know why?
But he's
going to
know Jesus in the last day.
No, do you know why?
Jesus in
the last day.
Do you know why?
No.
Why is not Muhammad? Why
is not Muhammad? He said.
Not dead. But Muhammad said, how is man not dead? How is Jesus not dead?
Why is Allah not dead?
Muhammad.
Jesus is not
dead.
Why is Muhammad not dead?
Amir. He said Allah.
He said,
I couldn't even save myself, let alone to save you. You could go beat up our Jews. Look at yourself. You should have moved yourself.
What is he going on about now?
Right? You
know
what I'm about? Look at please. That's the goodest powerful. It's the goodest powerful.
Wait. You say that Jesus got beat up by Jews.
He's the
you say that Jesus got beat up by Jews. Do you know why that happened? Do you even understand?
Because he was weak. He was weak.
It's not because he was weak.
So why he's crying? Why he's crying?
Wait, calm down.
I'm telling you why he's crying.
Now I ask him. I can give an answer.
Why he's crying?
I can answer, yeah?
Why he's crying?
I'm going to ask now, yeah?
I can be answered.
Do you know why he was? Why he got beat up by the Jews?
Yes.
Because...
Alhamdulillah for Islam. He's gonna justify God got beat up.
What
about when Jesus was on the cross and said, my Lord, my Lord, have you forsaken me?
He died to save our sins. That was the prophecy that was meant to happen. He came to die for our sins. That's it.
So you are justifying.
It was going to be allowed. It was going to be allowed. God was going to allow that to happen.
No, person. Let me understand this correctly. So you are justifying God getting beat up.
No, I'm not going to let you talk because you never let anyone else talk, yeah? You can't patronize me or touch me. He was talking to me, that's why I...
David, my question, I want to tell you something.
What if I...
If God and the Father, Jesus,
Jesus is your Dajjal. How can you love Jesus? Jesus is your Dajjal.
May Allah bless you.
How is Jesus your Dajjal?
You never heard in this course. No.
Why does your Dajjal lead you? This is what Jesus is going to do this time. So how do you not understand it? How do you not understand? Why don't you understand that Jesus comes about this?
This Christianity.
He's almost bombarding us, guys.
Yes. There's a line, Joel. He's not trying to understand. He doesn't understand the Old Testament. He doesn't understand the prophecies. He doesn't understand why Jesus is coming.
I'm willing to listen,
understand.
But it's like he's
going to
listen.
We are speaking.
So basically, he wants to just say, oh, well, I don't understand this, so Islam is superior.
I'm going
to
say that.
It doesn't work like that.
I'm going to say that.
Why?
He hasn't made him clear.
Why don't you want to let it sink into your head? Because God's nature is different. Your Allah, I don't know about your Allah.
One at a time.
You're saying your Allah is out there. In the Bible, God has shown this pattern that he comes down and he speaks to man face to face. Not once, not twice. Throughout the Old Testament.
What is the Bible? No one can speak to God face to face.
Of course not. Yeah. And I'll show you why.
He says, excuse me. You just question to yourself.
I've just made a claim. Can I back it up?
Can I back it up?
Did you hear what you said? You just said right now, yeah? That God comes down, speaks to prophets face to face, and he said, no, of course you can't. And he said, of course you can't. You just...
No, in the Bible he said, no one can speak to God face to face. And he said, yes.
Wait, can I back it up? Make sense to you. Why?
Did you hear what you said, bro?
No, I understand what you said.
You know,
the reason why I said
I'm trying to tell you to be quiet, bro.
Let's go.
Remember his claim that God spoke to Moses face to face.
Let me back it up. We understand. I've said that. The reason why I said that is because of this. Then the Lord replied, yeah? Moses asked to see God's glory, right? This is what God said. Then the Lord replied, I will make my goodness pass before you. I will announce to you the meaning of my name, yeah? Jehovah, the Lord, I show kindness and mercy to anyone I want to, but you may not see the glory of my face. For any man may not see me and live. Right? So God is talking to Moses face to face. Moses asked to see God's glory. God says, I will show you my glory, but you will see my back. If you see my face, you will surely...
But you should be face to face, he said.
So,
yeah, bro, that's the face. You fuck is the back.
Wait. But when he's asking to see glory, listen, you don't know the Bible, so when I teach you...
You're silly.
You're moving silly. So when God is face to face, Hey, wait, please, like, you guys, man, come on.
Christians,
be sensible.
Just sensible. Be honest. Be sincere.
If you're going to follow this guy,
Christianity.
It will lead you to hell. I'm not going to lie to you.
I'll tell you this straight.
Whether you take it or leave it. I'm a Christian. I believe the word of the Bible.
This guy's got a very loud voice and a lot of people are behind it.
But the thing is, it's simple. When God says, I will make my goodness pass before you and I'll announce to you the meaning of my name, Jehovah the Lord. I show kindness and mercy to anyone I want to, but you may not see the glory of my face. Right? So he's in a glorified state.
Okay,
saying that you cannot see me, yeah, face to face in my glorified state, because you will surely die. But you can see my back pass, right?
Okay. That's what he's saying. Please, brother, let's understand. I'm having a dialogue. But then men don't speak to God face to face
throughout the Bible.
I know you speak.
They will tell you this.
No, it's not true.
So as Muslims, you claim to know God, you don't even understand the Bible. How can you not understand it?
God spoke to Moses face to face.
Showed him his what? Did he say face?
Brother,
do you understand what I said? So if he said, see the glory of the Lord, I let him read different.
I was silent. No, he's not going to reply. Can I come back?
Only Jesus.
Adam,
Shamsi, I know you like your voice. Wait, man.
He's listening all the time.
He's asked me a question.
So you said God spoke to Moses face to face, correct?
Face to face, yeah?
Did he speak to face to face or God give him his back?
Hold on. Did you understand what I just said?
I'm just asking you. God spoke to him face to face. Which one?
Okay, can I tell you?
Yeah, now go on.
Now listen, God spoke to him face to face, right?
Okay.
Moses asked to see what? Good. What did Moses ask to see?
I'll let you read it.
God's glory.
Thank you.
So
he wants to see God's glory, right? His glorified state. And what did God say to him? I will show you. Hold on. I will make my goodness pass before you. I will announce to you the meaning of my name, Jehovah the Lord. I show kindness and mercy to anyone I want to. But you may not see the glory of my face. So in a glorified, so hold on, logically, in a glorified state, you cannot see God face to face.
Okay,
that's
so
why he should
understand you,
Moses. So wait, you don't understand. You want to talk my point is, you cannot see God in his glorified state. That's why when Jesus came down, he was in a lesser glory. We could comprehend his look.
Okay,
that's why he could claim to be.
Okay, I understand.
So in a glorified state, you cannot see God.